My name is Dr. Matt Hale. In this video, I'm going to show you how to create a 16x9 horizontal thumbnail for your YouTube videos, as well as 9x16 vertical covers that you can use for Instagram Reels or YouTube Shorts. Your thumbnail and the title of your video is honestly more important than the quality or the substance of your video content. You can make the best, most tightly edited video in the world, but if no one stops to click on it, it doesn't matter. So the big takeaway here, do not rely on auto-generated thumbnails if your goal is to get more views or subscribers or followers. Make good thumbnails. They need to make sense with your brand or aesthetic. It needs to look professional and be legible, and it should fit the niche or audience that you're trying to connect with. All right, let's open Photoshop and get started. And in order to do that, I'm gonna jump over to VoiceOver now.
First things first, we need to define the dimensions of our canvas. This choice is going to be determined by the platform that you use to publish your content. For YouTube videos, your thumbnail must be 1280 pixels wide by 720 pixels tall. So you would click here under Width and enter that value in. And make sure that this box here is set to pixels. Then click in the box below Height and enter your value. For vertically oriented video content like Instagram Reels or YouTube Shorts, your thumbnail, or what Instagram calls a cover, should be 1080 pixels wide by 1920 pixels tall. Once you've entered the correct dimensions, click Create, and you'll see your blank canvas. All right, so now we need to bring the images that we're going to work with here into our project. You can do this several ways. You can drag and drop your image into the project, like this, or you can select, copy, and then paste your image into your project. If your image is a bit too big, select it with the Move tool. That's the cursor or the standard tool that you'll start with when you open Photoshop. The keyboard shortcut for the Move tool is the letter V. With your image selected, and you'll know it's selected if you see the correct layer highlighted in the bottom right-hand layers panel, hit Command plus T. This will let you transform and thus resize your image. Click on one of the handles on the image and drag to resize it. If you only want to transform one dimension of the image, in this case, let's say the height, you can hold Shift while clicking and dragging a handle to make the image taller, and it won't affect the image's width. Okay, so now let's say we want to remove the background or isolate our subject. You can do this a lot of different ways in Photoshop. For now, let's use the quick selection tool. You can either click the tool, which is the fourth from the top in the tools panel, or you can press the W key. Make sure that you're using the quick selection tool and not the object selection or magic wand. Both are useful tools, but let's make sure that you're on the quick selection tool. Click and hold the fourth tool button to see its alternate functions. Or you can hold Shift and hit the tool's keyboard shortcut, which again is the letter W. This will allow you to cycle through any tool's alternate functions. All right, with the quick selection tool, let's click Select Subject at the top of the screen. Then you should see a dashed line, or what is sometimes called marching ants, around your selection. If this works, well, great. If not, you can manually paint over your subject with the quick selection brush. Use the left and right bracket keys to decrease or increase your brush size. Then click and move your cursor over what you want to select. If you accidentally select too much, you can subtract things from your selection by holding the Option key while clicking and dragging your cursor over the image. You can then either add a layer mask by clicking the Add a Layer Mask button down here at the bottom of the Layers panel. It looks like the Japanese flag. Or you could just copy and paste your selection by hitting Command plus C and then Command plus V. I'll show you both. Create a new layer by clicking the Create a New Layer button down here. So let's say you have your subject isolated and you want to put him, her, it, or they in front of a solid color or even a gradient background. Easy enough. Create a new layer by clicking the Create a New Layer button down here. Make sure to drag that layer below your subject so your subject will be visible. Then, with your new layer selected, we'll use either the Paint Bucket tool to create a solid color or the Gradient tool to produce a gradient. The keyboard shortcut for this tool is the letter G. For a solid color, we'll select a color either up here in the right-hand corner, or you can change the foreground color down here on the left-hand side of the Tools panel. Click the background, and it will be filled in with the color that you've chosen. I'll undo that by hitting Command plus Z, and then let me show you the Gradient tool. So, click and hold the Paint Bucket tool, or press and hold Shift while hitting G to shuffle through your alternate functions. For the Gradient tool, you'll need to select two colors. Click the foreground color, and then select another color for the background color. These are the two colors that you'll be gradiating, if that's a word. Then click, hold, and drag your cursor onto your canvas. I tried this a few times to get the hang of it. I think it makes more sense to experiment here than to have me explain it verbally. Play around and it'll make sense to you. Next, let's create a border or a frame around our thumbnail. To do that, I like to use the rectangle tool. Select the tool or press the keyboard shortcut U. At the top of the screen, select a fill color for your shape, and then I'd also make sure that you don't have a stroke or a line around the shape. Then click and drag to create your rectangle. I'd opt for long, skinny rectangles here. You could then draw more rectangles around the other three sides of your thumbnail, but what I like to do is this. I'll change over to the Move tool, select the newly formed rectangle, and then copy and paste it. I'll then reposition it to the other side of the thumbnail, then repeat, select, copy, and paste. For the horizontal bars, you can rotate the copy-pasted rectangle. Select it, hit Command plus T to transform it, and then you can type the value of either 90 or negative 90, doesn't really matter, into the rotate box. Then reposition the rectangle. If you need to resize the now horizontal rectangle, remember to click it, hit Command plus T, and then click and drag the handle on the side of the rectangle while holding down Shift. Once you've got that where you want it, copy and paste it again, and then reposition the new rectangle at the bottom of the thumbnail. I then like to merge all four of these shapes to create a single frame. To do that, select one of the rectangles, then click the others while holding down the Shift key. This will let you select multiple layers. Once you've got all four sides of your border selected, hit Command plus E to merge them into a single object. Then, let's say you decide to change the color of the frame. Maybe you want to fill it with a gradient of colors. You'll need to first rasterize it. To do that, right-click the layer and then select Rasterize Layer. Since I mentioned the whole gradient border thing, let's do that. First, you need to select your frame. You can use either the magic wand or quick selection tool. So to select the full frame, I'll click and drag over the entire thumbnail. Now, let's switch over to the gradient tool. Select your two colors, and then click and drag. The gradient will only be applied to the selected portion of the image, which should be your border. Now, let's move our subject above the border by dragging that layer higher than the frame or border layer. Next, let's add a few layer effects to our subject. You can do a lot here, but I'll just show you some of the more common effects that YouTubers tend to use in their thumbnails. To get to the Layer Styles menu, you can either double-click on a layer, or you can click Layer from the menu bar, and then Layer Style, and select a particular layer styling. First up, let's add a line, or what Adobe calls a stroke, around our subject. Click the arrow next to Stroke to engage the effect. You can then change the color and size or line weight of the stroke. Or we can add an outer glow to the subject. You can play around with these various parameters and make your subject appear as if they're glowing. Or you could add a drop shadow. After you've applied whatever styles that you want to your selected layers, let's add some text. Click the Type tool or press T. You can type horizontally or vertically. You can also create vertical or horizontal type masks. Play around with all of those. For now, I'm just going to add some horizontal text. For a real thumbnail, this message ought to be interesting or engaging or relevant. For now, I'm just going to type some nonsense in here. Then, when you're done, press the Escape key. Now, you can shift back to the Move tool to reposition your text. If you want some of your text to fall behind your subject, you can simply drag the text layer below the layer that your isolated subject is on. You can also resize your text or double-click it to edit the font or change the text color and so on. After that, just export your content and you're good to upload it onto any platform. Okay, so there's a lot more that you can do to create thumbnails or covers that will stand out and attract a viewer's attention. But with these basic tools and techniques, you should be able to develop your own aesthetic and a cohesive brand identity that is well-defined, legible, and engaging. So that's it for today. If you found this helpful, please like the video. It helps me and the channel out a lot. And consider subscribing. Thanks for watching. Bye.